राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा संवाद सेकंड टॉक ऑन द पुलिस इमेज। फ्रेंड्स, आई वॉज रीडिंग अदर डे न्यूज दैट अ जर्मन पुलिस फोर्स हैज वॉर्न पेरेंट्स अगेंस्ट पोस्टिंग फोटोग्राफ्स ऑफ देयर चिल्ड्रन टू फेसबुक पब्लिकली। द न्यूज गोज ऑन टू रिपोर्ट दैट अ चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन चैरिटी The NSPCC said in a statement, I quote, all parents should feel free to enjoy taking photos of their children and sharing them with friends and family. However, we should all be careful when posting photos online. The statement added that if parents were worried about a photograph of their child had fallen into the wrong hands, they should contact the Internet Watch Foundation, the Child Exploitation and Online Protection Center, or the helpline. This particular advisory from police could increase the caring police image among parents and also among children who are potentially prevented from falling into the trap of exploiters of child photos in our society. Informal contacts with citizens are essential. In our villages, even today, mornings and late afternoon are still full of social lives in which people of all age group get together in various groups and talk about daily lives and daily problems, including crime-related issues informally. Police, by joining such lively meetings, can actually help in identifying problems and also can help in finding community-oriented solutions. Our urban areas may have certain areas which are having higher crime rates, even can invoke dangers and disorderly. Besides proper patrolling, our police can organize contacts of insider to outsider and vice versa. For example, few people from difficult areas can be taken to absolute peaceful areas and vice versa, and can see the difference themselves. How a peacefully living area is very essential for our common development. Talking about health and schools with residents and others can also reduce the negative impact of police formal contacts in case of arrest, questions, etc. Friends, if an immediate neighborhood is full of complaints of law and order, including crime, it significantly shapes the overall image of the police of the area, city and the state as a whole. More informal interactions will significantly enhance the positive perception and even will be helpful in difficult time when police would expect full cooperation from our communities. Media can affect citizens' approval of police job performance or their police perception of image in country like India. Better social cohesion and informal social control, which are quite evident in our rural areas, can further enhance the police image. For example, if neighbors get very well along and could rely on each other, they would feel the same way to interact with the police and the other way around. If neighbors share difficult relations and less similar values, then they would opt for more formal contacts with the police. The first group of people will believe that we share duty with police for safe and peaceful neighborhood and the other way around. Police are particularly concerned about the media's influence on attitudes toward them. Any highly publicized event can have critical impact, and if negative publicity is inflicted, then the chances that the whole police force is looked down is very high. Imagine, if a group of people simply lies upon media carrying negative publicity again and again, it can have long-lasting impact on the individual police officer, but also on the morale of the force as a whole. We need to identify small and big measures which can enhance public acceptance of public authority, which can further strengthen the public order in our society. We can publicize stories and seminars which demonstrate increased public confidence in police, which would boost cooperation for effective policing. If public has higher confidence and better support, government would also expand police funding and better facilities and better amenities for police, which will further have positive impact in their performance and image. Public opinion is crucial. Instead of simply local lawmaker or executive authority evaluate and monitor police activities, one gets pleased to see when public overwhelmingly supports continuation of particular police official. Instead of isolated stories, this can become a daily feature. Police too can tailor to specific community concerns. For example, concern of area with lot of children would have different expectations from police than area with lot of elderly people. The same applies to communities pursuing different religions and belonging to different castes. Sensitivity, therefore, is a key word for mutual success. The mandate for a child-friendly police station arising out of Juvenile Justice Act 2015 outlines the steps that can be taken for the protection of rights of children in need of care and protection, as well as the children in conflict with the law. One such station in Pune has been inaugurated, and more such can go a long way, particularly in this pandemic time. We have significant street children problem. These children with unfortunate lives, if have any bad experience, can see police as an enemy, a figure which generates fear than faith. If these children have positive image and if police show extra sensitivity and care, this can transform the socially caring image of our police. Harrowing experiences like actions that could humiliate them either verbally or physically, removal of children against their will and without any safe and secure alternatives, and allegations of sexual abuse all constitute lifetime image of police in the minds of these children. But friends, these are curable. These are curable practices with tremendous positive results. These children will see police as change of positive personal and social change. Here, the police can perform the role of a social doctor so that the street children's injuries are cured and they can start aspiring for better development. Police visiting schools in informal manner and talking to children, school teachers and parents can bring so much solace to the school community. To enhance the performance and professionalism of SSB on the borders while on duty, and to build the image of SSB as a people-friendly force, Border Interaction Team has been constituted, comprising male and female personnel, with the purpose of checking and frisking at the designated checkpost, authorized routes and elsewhere in the AOR where required on the international border. It is also aimed at to maximize operational achievements through meaningful intelligence-based operations using specially trained crews all along the border. Another important, for example, Jharkhand Child Friendly Police Campaign have provided a definite child-friendly and sensitive face to Jharkhand police. Another important initiative, cashless and non-contact citizen-friendly traffic enforcement, regular briefing is given to all the enforcement officers for implementation of people's friendly police. Raipur Range has launched Citizen Cop as a citizen-friendly mobile app to empower every citizen to be a powerful cop. This has brought law enforcement authorities a click away from the common people. In Chandigarh, Chandigarh Mobile Police Station, as reported in 2018, was to provide residents, especially backwards and weaker sections of society, women and senior citizens, with services at their doorsteps. Significant changes are taking place in our societies. These mobile police stations farm in Chandigarh are stationed beyond the planned sectors and mostly in the jurisdiction of areas mostly inhabited by the migrant population. Each MPS has a staff of 6 persons and is equipped with a wireless base station and computer operator for quick transmission of message and other logistics. The staff members undertake the receipt of petty complaints and resolve it on the spot and carry out servant, tenant and even PG verifications. They receive complaints regarding the loss of documents and generate their computer receipts instantly. Similar mobile police stations in metro cities can be tremendously helpful. As I said, significant changes are taking place in our society. Police response mechanisms are substantially reported to be improved than previously, as people use mobile applications and resolve their non-cognizable cases such as loss of identity documents without visiting police stations, or applications to file loss reports introduced by various police organizations of states. These have substantially reduced the number of citizens visiting police stations. Under community policing, there are initiatives in various states which show how a community can write to police where there are no street lights, and how it leads to chain snatching, etc., and how the police helps in resolving a problem of creating a street light. It reinforces actually the mutual governance aspects of law and order between police and general administration of a state and peaceful society as a whole. The Rashtriya Raksha University has started number of programs, including among others tourism policing, which help our police personnel to improve their communication skills. It is being organized in collaboration with the Gujarat government, and the results are there for one to happily see. It identifies tourism problems, risk areas, how to resolve problems, feedback collection, among others. Highly trained police personnel will be a big booster to our economy, and very importantly, the tourists, which are increasingly exploring our great civilization. While all IT-led initiatives and measures are essential, friends, ours is a society where the true and friendly human face of police can solve many of the day-to-day problems of law and order and bring peaceful society. Thus, community or society-driven, individual-driven initiatives have huge scope to realize the potential of the proverb, "Friend in need is a friend indeed." And this context applies to police, whom we all thank, respect for their services amidst challenges, and yet we all can aspire for much better and much effective help for a stable and peaceful neighborhood and society. These are some of the informal mechanisms and measures, and this is how our society is evolving, and this is how our police force are responding to the growing challenges of the society. It is symbiotic relationship which is growing and which is helping our society. in the last, I would say, our Mitra police, aiming for depicting citizenship-friendly police of India and their stories is something which the Rashtriya Raksha University is very much willing and would like ability to do to contribute on part of this university to positive and friendly image of our police. Thank you. Jai Hind.